Good morning students, welcome back to Maths class. In the last session we discussed the general form of a pair of linear equations, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals 0, and how to represent graphically or algebraically this pair of linear equation. Now today there are three possibilities when we draw the graph in a graph sheet. The first one is the lines will be intersecting. The second one is maybe they are parallel lines, and the third is coincident lines. Without plotting the points in a graph sheet, we can check it using some formula. We'll see that. See, I had written three examples here. The first one is x minus 2y equals 0, 3x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. These are the two equations, one pair of linear equations in two variables. Now, the general form of a pair of linear equation is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals 0, where a1 is the coefficient of x in the first equation, b1 is the coefficient of y, and c1 is the constant for first equation. And in the second equation, a2 is the coefficient of x, b2 is the coefficient of y, and c2 is the constant. See, here is a table. We have to write the ratio, what is a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2. See here, in the first equation, coefficient of x is 1. So, a1 is 1. So, I am going to write the ratio a1, 1 by a2. In the second equation, the coefficient of x is 3. So, a1 by a2 is 1 by 3. For b1 by b2, first equation, b1 is minus 2 by b2 is 4. Now, C1 is first equation, there is no constant, so 0 is the constant. 0 by, here the constant number is minus 20. So, here I have written A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2, where A1 is the coefficient of X, A2 is the coefficient of X in the second equation. Similarly, B1, B2, C1, C2. Now, we will compare the ratio. So, when we compare the ratio, we will write 1 by 3 is not equal to minus 2 by 4. So, these two ratios are not equal. So, we will write A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2. A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2. If A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2, then the graphical representation will be the lines will intersect at a point. Lines intersect one point. And what is the algebraic interpretation is we will get a unique solution. Unique solution means one solution. So when you do the graph, we have only one solution. So if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the lines will intersect at a point and we will get a unique solution. Now, we will see the second pair of linear equations. We will write A1 by A2. A1 by A2 is 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2. Again, B1 by B2 is 3 by 6. 3 by 6 is equal to, again, 1 by 2. C1 by C2 is minus 9 by minus 18. Again, that is 1 by 2. So, here A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2, all the three are equal. So, we will write it here. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. When all the three ratios are equal, the graphical representation will be coincident lines. This is coincident lines. Coincident means one line on the other, you will get same line you will get. And the solution, algebraic interpretation is, if the lines are coincident, infinite number of solution. So, if the ratio, all the ratios are equal, we will get coincident lines in the graph and infinite number of solutions we will get. And in the third example, A1 by A2 is, A1 is 1, so 1 by 2. B1 by B2 is 2 by 4, that is nothing but 1 by 2. C1 by C2 is minus 4 by minus 12, that is 1 by 3. So here how can we write the ratio? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. In this case, how will be the graph? Graph will be parallel lines. We will get two parallel lines when we draw the graph. And the solution, what about the solution? If the lines are parallel, there will not be any solution. No solution. So, these are the three possibilities. By checking the ratio of the constant, we can see that whether the lines will intersect, whether we will get a unique solution, whether the lines will be coincident or are they parallel. So, this is very important, this ratio. Question will be asked for 1 mark to check the ratio and find out whether it's a unique solution or no solution or infinite number of solutions. Now, if parallel lines, if we are getting, there is no solution, then we will say this is an inconsistent solution, we'll see. So, question will be asked where the pair of linear equations are inconsistent or consistent. Only for no solution, it is inconsistent. For unique solution and infinite number of solution, both it is consistent. So, question can be asked, check the ratio and find whether the lines are parallel, coincident or intersecting at a point. We should check the ratio. One more question, check the ratio and find whether the lines are consistent or inconsistent. Then also we have to find the ratio and check. For unique solution and infinite number of solutions, it is consistent. For no solution, it is inconsistent. So, if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, no need to see C1 by C2. Directly we can write the lines will intersect at one point. If they are intersecting at one point, there is only one solution. And if all the ratios are equal, then the lines will be coincident. If the lines are coincident, there are many solutions. And if the ratio A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, not equal to C1 by C2, then the lines will be parallel and there is no solution and it will be inconsistent. Now we will move on to the second exercise. Exercise 3.2. First question, in the first main, there are two subdivisions, both you have to do graph. Form the pair of linear equations in the following problems and find the solutions graphically. First question, 10 students of class 10th took part in a maths quiz. If the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, find the number of boys and girls who took part in the quiz. So they are asking to find the number of girls and boys in the quiz competition. So here we have to draw the graph and find out the solution. That is, we have to find out how many boys and how many girls took part in the competition. So here there are 10 students. So as we did in the last session, we will write, let the number of girls be X and number of boys be Y. First question, let the number of girls be X and number of boys be Y. Now we will read the first sentence. 10 students of class 10 took part in a quiz competition. So totally how many students? 10 students. So here X girls and Y boys, how can we represent as a linear equation in two variables? Number of girls plus number of boys, together it is 10. So this is our first equation. So now I'll change this equation. Y equals 10 minus X. So now we have to get the value for X and Y here, and we should draw the first straight line for this equation. And the second equation is, if the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, how we will represent that one as an equation? If the number of girls, what is the number of girls? It is X. Number of girls is means you have to write equals 4 more than the number of boys. 4 more means it is plus. 4 more or 4 greater, whatever term comes, plus sign we have to put. Than the boys, what is the number of boys? It is Y. So this is the second equation. Number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys. So here when we write, we will write the equation in terms of y. So I'll take 4 to the left side. X minus 4 is equal to y, or y is equal to x minus 4. Now we will do the table and we will plot the points. So here, whenever we will do the graph, we know here number of boys and number of girls we have to find out. So we will get a unique solution. We will get number of girls and number of boys. Lines will intersect at one point. So when we do the values of x and y in this table, we have to see that whether we are getting a common point in when you write the set of solutions. So we'll start with first equation. So if I write 1, 10 minus 1, it is 9. Now I'll go for 3. You can continuously write 1, 2, 3, but it will take many number of solutions. So I'll go for 3. So 10 minus 3 will become 7. Then 5. 10 minus 5, it is 5. Then 7. 10 minus 7, it is 3. Again, I'll repeat, the equation is y equals 10 minus x. As we are giving values for x, we are getting values for y. Now we will stop this and we will see the second equation, how we are getting. In both the table, we have a common value for x and y. Then only the correctly we will get the graph, easily the lines will intersect. So here, if we start with 1, 1 minus 4, it is minus 3. If we go for 2, again we are getting negative numbers. Here there is no negative number. So we will see a positive number. So which number if you write, we will get a positive number. If I write 5, 5 minus 4, 1. So I will start with 5. So if x is 5, y equals 5 minus 4. So I will get 1. So 6, 6 minus 4, it is 2. Again 7, 7 minus 4, it is 3. Again 8, 8 minus 4, it is 4. Now stop, see that, is there any common term, common solution in both the table? See here, x is 3, y is 7. No, it is not here. X is 7 and y is 3. See this one. X is 7 and y is 3. Here also, x is 7, y is 3. So, now itself we got the answer before doing the graph. The solution is 7 and 3. Means, we have taken x as number of girls. So, number of girls is 7 and the number of boys is 3. We'll check whether it is correct. See, number of girls, x, will be equal to 4 more than number of boys. I told you 7 is the common number here, number of girls. If I write instead of x, 7, 4 plus, what is the number of boys? 3. See, we are getting same equation. 7 is equal to 7. So, before doing the graph, see that in the table, both the table, we have a common solution. X value and y value should be same. Now, we will start plotting the points in the graph sheet. The first equation is y equals 10 minus x. Here are the values for x and y. So we'll plot the points. First set is 1, 9. So here 1, 9. Next set is 3, 7. 3, 7. Third set is 5, 5. Next, 7, 3. 7, 3. 3. So, we have to draw the line. When you draw it in the graph sheet, you will get it correctly. Yeah, the lines are not properly intersected. So this is the first equation. So that is y equals 10 minus x, or x plus y is equal to 10. Anywhere you can write y equals 10. Any one equation you can write. Now the second one is 5, 1. So here 5, 1. Second coordinate, 6 and 2. 6, 2. 6, 2. 6, 2. Third one is 7, 3. So where is our 7, 3 point? This is 7, 3. 8, 4, 8, 4. Somewhere here. 8. So now we will join this. So after drawing the straight line, if the line is very small, you can extend it on either side and draw, mark the arrow mark, because the line can be extended as we like. Extend the line here also. Draw the arrow mark here. Now you see that both the straight lines will intersect at a point, and the intersecting point is the solution. So here x coordinate 7 and y coordinate 3. 7, 3 is the solution. So here we have to find the number of boys and number of girls. Therefore, number of girls is equal to, we had told x is the number of girls. So number of girls is 7. And number of boys, y is 3. So through graph, we've got the number of girls and number of boys. The second question is, 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50. 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50. Whereas 7 pencils and 5 pens together cost rupees 46. Find the cost of 1 pencil and 1 pen through graph. So here, pencil and pen. So we will write, let the cost of 1 pencil is equal to rupees x, and the cost of 1 pen is equal to rupees y. So any 1 as x and 1 as y. 1 pencil x rupees. So 5 pencil how much? 5x. And 7 pen together rupees 50. So how we will write? 5 pencil means 5 into x. And 7 pencil, pen cost y rupees. So 7 pen, 7y rupees. Together cost 50 rupees. So this is our first equation. The second equation is, whereas 7 pencil. So 7x plus 5 pen. So 5y is equal to rupees 46. This is the second equation. Find the cost of 1 pen and 1 pencil that we have to find out. So what is the value of x and y we have to find? So we'll convert the equation. 7y is equal to 50 minus 5x. Y is equal to 50 minus 5x by 7. So here 7x plus 5y is 46. 5y equals 46 minus 7x. Y equals 46 minus 7x by 5. So we'll do the table. X and y. So here, as divided by 7, denominator is 7. We have to select such numbers so that this, after subtracting, the number should be divisible by 7. So which number? If you take 1, 5 into 1, 5. 50 minus 5, 45, it is not divisible by 7. So, 2 also, 10. 50 minus 10 is not. We will go for 3. So, if x is 3, 50 minus 5 into 3 by 7. This is y. Is equal to 50 minus 15 by 7. 50 minus 15 is 35. So, 35 by 7 will get 5. So, the first set of points is 3 and 5. Now we will see next to which number we can select so that it will be divisible by 7. Next 3 over. Now 5, 6, 4. 4 if you take. 4 if you take, we won't. Minus 4 if you take. See here, minus 4 if you take. Y equals 50 minus 5 into minus 4 by 7. That is 50 minus into minus plus. So it is 20 by 7. 70 by 7, we will get 10. So minus 4 and 10, we will get. Next to which number we have to take? We will take 10 and take. If you take 10 here, x is 10. 10 into 5, 50. 50 minus 50 becomes 0. 0 by any number is 0. 50 minus 5 into 10. So 5 into 10 is 50. 50 minus 50 by 7, 0 by 7, it is 0. So we got 3 set of values. Now we will stop this. We will see the second. Now here we have to get this divisible by 5. X and Y. So we here also we have to select such a number for X so that it will be after subtracting it will be divisible by 5. So here we will see 3. We will write here Y equals 46 minus 7 into 3 by 5 is equal to 46 minus 21 by 3 equals 25 by 5. We will get 25 by 5, it is 5. So we got 5. Next, which number we have to take? 7. If we take 8, we see, go to 8, x is 8, 7 8s are 56. We will get y equals 46 minus 7 into 8 by 5. 7 8s are 56. 46 minus 56 is minus 10. Minus 10 by 5, we will get minus 2. So take minus 2. If you take minus 2, you will see y equals 46 minus 7 into minus 2 by 5. 46 plus 14 by 5. 46 plus 14, 60. 60 by 5. It is 12. So this is the third set of points. So here, first set of points. First 3, 5. 3, 5. So here both the table we have a common solution 3 and 5. So we will got the same point 3, 5. Next is minus 4, 10. Minus 4, 10. So here around here we have to mark minus 4, 10. So mark it minus 4, 10. Next 10, 0. Here 10, 0. This on x axis 10, 0. So now we have to join all these points. So using scale, we have to join the straight line. The next set is again 3, 5. The same point 3, 5. This is 3, 5. 8 minus 2. 8 minus 2. So here we will mark 8 minus 2. Third point is minus 2, 12. Minus 2, 12. Here it will get minus 2, 12. So the points are 1, minus 2, 12 here. Second point is here. Third point is here. So join it. So this with this you have to join. So these are the two lines. Both the straight lines will intersect at 3, 5. So the solution is 3, 5. What is this 3, 5? We have to find the cost of pencil and pen. Therefore, cost of a pencil is X. Cost of a pencil equals X is equal to rupees. X is, what is the X coordinate? We have to see. 3. Rupees 3. Therefore, cost of a pen. Y is the letter. Y is 5. Rupees 5. And we have to write a scale. Scale we will write here. X axis and Y axis. Here we are discussing the cost of pen and pencil and we have written 1, 2, 3 in the x axis and y axis. So x axis 1 centimeter is equal to rupees 1. Y axis also same thing, 1 centimeter is equal to rupees 1. You have to put the arrow mark, write the equation in both the lines. Second main is on comparing the ratios A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2. Find out whether the lines representing the following pair of linear equations intersect at a point, are parallel or coincident. So we have to compare the ratios and check whether the lines will intersect, parallel or coincident. So one mark question. The first question is 5x minus 4y plus 8 equals 0, 7x plus 6y minus 9 equals 0. First we will write a1 by a2. a1 by a2 equals 5 by 7. Then b1 by b2 is equal to minus 4 by 6. If you want, we can cancel. It is minus 2 by 3. See, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. If you understood, then no need to find out c1 by c2. Because the first ratio said c1 by c2, right? 8 by minus 9 is equal to the same. Can't guess. See, now a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. Then no need to see c1 by c2. Directly we can write, if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, we have to write whether the lines intersect at a point, parallel or coincident. What we can say? The lines will intersect at a point. Lines intersect at a point. Intersect at a point. If the lines intersect at a point, what about the solution? Unique solution. There is only one solution. Last two questions we did, only unique solution, because both the lines intersect at a point. Unique solution. So whether this is consistent or inconsistent, only consistent. The question is only about lines intersect at a point or not. Just I told you, lines will intersect at a point means unique solution and consistent. Now we will see the second question. 9x plus 3y plus 12 equals 0. 18x plus 6y plus 24 equals 0. So first we will write a1 by a2. a1 by a2 is 9 by 18 equals 1 by 2. b1 by b2 is equal to 3 by 6. That is also equal to 1 by 2. c1 by c2, constant, 12 by 24 is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. If all the three ratios are equal, then lines are coincident. C-O-I-N-C-I-D-E-N. One line on the top, another line will get. Same points will be there. Solution when we consider, x coordinate, y coordinates will be same. So coincident lines we will get. If they are coincident, what about the solution? Infinite number of solution, and it is, they are consistent. Now the third question. Third question is 6x minus 3y plus 10 equals 0. 2x minus y plus 9 equals 0. a1 by a2 equals 6 by 2. 6 by 2 when you cancel, 3 by 1 as ratio will write by 1. Then b1 by b2. b1 by b2 is equal to minus 3 by minus 1. Minus minus will cancel. We will write 3 by 1. c1 by c2 is equal to 10 by 9. So here we got a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but not equal to c1 by c2. If a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, not equal to c1 by c2, then the lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. If the lines are parallel, then there is no solution and it is inconsistent. Now, the next mean, third mean. On comparing the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, find out whether the following pair of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent. Already explained in the second main, the similar way we have to do this. Here is the first question, whether it is consistent or inconsistent, we have to see. See here, equals to 5, it is written. So we have to take the constant also to the left side so that it will be in the standard form. So here we can write minus 5 is equal to 0. So equal to 7, minus 7 is equal to 0. First to write it in the standard form, then we have to write the ratio. So a1 by a2 equals 3 by 2. b1 by b2 equals 2 by minus 3. See here itself, a1 by a2 is 3 by 2 and b1 by b2 is 2 by minus 3. Are they equal? No. So here no need to check c1 by c2. Directly we can write a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Therefore, unique solution, lines will intersect and it is consistent. They asked whether it is consistent or not. So consistent. So when a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, lines are consistent, unique solution intersecting at a point. Next question. Third question, 3 by 2x plus 5 by 3y is equal to 7. Here we will write it as minus 7 is equal to 0 and here minus 14 is equal to 0. So we will write a1 by a2 is equal to 3 by 2 divided by 9. I will write divided by 9 like this. 3 by 2 divided by 9. When you divide a number, we have to take the reciprocal. 9 means 9 by 1. Take the reciprocal and multiply. So 9 dividing by 9 means multiply with 1 by 9. So here we will cancel. 3 ones are 3 threes. So we will get 1 by 6. So a1 by a2 is 1 by 6. Now we will see b1 by b2 is equal to 5 by 3 divided by minus 10. So here 5 by 3 into minus 10 means it is minus 10 by 1. So reciprocal will become 1 by minus 10. Cancel. We will get minus 2. So 1 by 3 into minus 2. Minus 6. Normally this negative sign we won't write it in the denominator. Always we will keep it in the numerator. So minus 1 by 6. We will write. See a1 by a2 is 1 by 6. And b1 by b2 is minus 1 by 6. Are they equal? No. So a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. That means lines will intersect, unique solution and consistent. So this is also consistent. Now the fifth question. Fifth question, we'll write a1 by a2. a1 by a2 equals 4 by 3 divided by 2. It is 4 by 3 into 2 means 2 by 1, it is 1 by 2. Cancel, we will get 2 by 3. Next, b1 by b2 equals 2 by 3. So here we will write minus 8 equals 0 and minus 12 equals 0. So 2 by 3, c1 by c2 is equal to minus 8 by minus 12. Minus and minus will cancel. 4 2s are 4 3s are. We got 2 by 3. So all the 3 ratios are equal. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2 means lines will be coincident, many solutions and consistent. So this is also consistent. That's all for today. Thank you, students.